The tundra on the north slope of Alaska is just beginning to recover from a rare event in a remote part of the world. Global warming may have helped cause the largest tundra fire in Alaskan history. And scientists say the fire may have even aggravated climate change.
So this is the soil here. You could see how much carbon was lost. All this carbon here went up to the atmosphere once this area combusted.
For the lower 48, in terms of climate change, the fire itself adds a lot more carbon to the atmosphere, which causes more global warming.
In July 2007, a fire raged above the Arctic Circle, not far from the Tulik Lake Research Station. It burned 450 square miles, nearly the size of Los Angeles. The Anaktuvuk River fire was sparked by lightning during one of the hottest, driest summers in decades. Scientists were stunned at the scale of the fire.
This is a large landscape that's being changed. Whole watersheds are burned. The vegetation and soils interact with the climate, the atmosphere, and then the permafrost beneath them has been changed on a very large scale.
Researchers are now on a mission to collect water and weather data from the raw burn site and to design experiments to track the recovery of plant and animal habitat.
There are many potential implications for caribou. Caribou eat lichens in the wintertime. They eat a lot of them in the summer. They need lichens, and lichen recovery after fire takes a very long time.
The fire scorched an area increasingly vulnerable to a warming climate, and there are other disturbing changes going on.
Well, this is what we call a thermokarst feature. It's an area in the landscape where the ice that underlays the permafrost has melted, and so the soil and plants that are on top have fallen down. And what we're trying to do is relate the development of these thermokarsts to changes in the climate.
It appears to be a new phenomenon. People have been working here for 30 years in this North Slope landscape, and just now people are starting to notice that there are more of these features popping up. We know temperature is warming here. We know these are caused by melting.
Warming temperatures directly threaten the Arctic permafrost. From a few centimeters to hundreds of meters thick, the permanently frozen soil traps carbon, nitrogen, and other elements, which, if released by thawing, could add a colossal load of greenhouse gases to the atmosphere.
It's more than 25 years now, about 25 years of continuous records. And from these records, we can tell that permafrost temperature is warm, is increasing, especially on the north slope of Alaska. Well, it's definitely related directly to changes in climate or warming.
Ironically, some of the most important environmental research in the world is carried out in the shadow of the Trans-Alaska Pipeline, which carries warm crude from the largest oil field in North America. It is a constant reminder to scientists of the hydrocarbons responsible for climate change. The Alaskan oil pipeline runs 800 miles across 3 mountain ranges, 3 fault lines, and more than 800 rivers and streams.
Well, I guess you could say Tulik is in the backyard of the pipeline because this land was set aside by Congress for the transport of hydrocarbons. And we exist here because they didn't mind us being here, basically.
The pipeline is not just in Alaska's interest, it's in the national interest. It's a national asset and it's a huge economic driver.
Clearly, even though it's great for the state of Alaska to export as much oil as possible, it would probably be better for the climate, for the world, if we could slow down our use of energy a little bit and spin it out as long as possible so that the climate changes don't happen so rapidly.